So Valentine's Day is less than a week away, and many of us have our minds on love, including our kids. So for most parents, the idea of your preteens and teenage children dating probably brings up some feelings of fear and uncertainty. That's to put it nicely. Some That's parents it. Just don't want to deal with it at all.
That's right. That's
so
right.
Here to tell us all about it is a licensed social worker and president and CEO of Daniel, Jim Clark. Thank you so much.
And I brought you some flowers.
I'll receive it. Thank free, you.
Free, you know.
I know it's really tough for, like, you know, parents to think about their children doing this, exchanging flowers and gifts, having someone, a boyfriend or a girlfriend. How do you even start discussing this?
Hey, it's a great time, as I've always said. Use opportunities to talk to kids about a variety of different things, and particularly, you know, talking about healthy relationships, mm-hmm. strong relationships are really a great thing to do, particularly around a Valentine's Day. And lots of parents, you know, you might be nervous, but you got to understand, children, preteens, even elementary school, start to have these little crushes. And the more you're able to talk to children about these kind of crushes and what a healthy relationship is and what a bad relationship is, mm-hmm. those are ways to help that child.
How do you prepare to do that? Because you don't want to kind of wait till the last minute when you see them pop up with some flowers or a boyfriend or a girlfriend.
You
How do you kind
don't.
Of gear up to have that conversation?
Well, you can do it in a number of different ways. And we actually start to do it when we start to teach kids to say thank you and please. Those are relationship type of things. And so, like I say, I like to use the holiday or the Valentine's Day as a great day to talk to children about what the rules are, what are things that they should be thinking about. All children need a curfew, and particularly with preteens, you know, typically we're going to talk about they should usually be dating in pairs, in groups, you know, going to the mall together. You know, you always want to talk to your child, too, about what's appropriate, what's the age. I don't want my 16-year-old dating a 22-year-old. Mm-hmm. And you might be some parameters out there. One of the things I always tell people, make sure you know who your kids are going to be with. Mm-hmm. Any child who's going to date one of my children, I want to make sure I meet them first. No horn tooting at the curb. And, you know, make sure, too, that there are certain rules that you have even in your house. In our house, anytime the opposite sex was over, all the doors are always open. Those type of things, those are good things to make sure of, that those are non-negotiable type of topics, because what we want to do is teach children what's healthy relationship, what's a bad relationship, and prepare them for those type of things.
I know one of the biggest challenges, though, in getting all that across is the way you say it, the communication. So
absolutely.
How do you do it?
Well, absolutely. You want to be careful in terms of always being dictatorial. You know, one of the best things for teens, particularly in preteens, is to make sure that you're telling them why you're having this conversation. And no teen should ever go on a date that hasn't had the basic sex talk. Parents always, when do I talk to the kids about my the birds and the bees? Well, certainly before they start doing any kind of dating. And always, again, answer questions honestly. Be straight. This is how I felt. Maybe express some of your experiences that you had, particularly even heartbreaks that you had, you know? Be open about your own dating experiences. Everything isn't always hunky-dory, and that one boy who you really liked may have crushed your heart, but there's a lot of other fish in the sea,
exactly.
As my dad used to say. So those are just some of the kind of the basics, but we want to prepare our children, understand that maturity is happening before you see the facial hairs and all those other things, and make sure that you're talking to them about healthy relationships. 1 in 10 kids are involved or know someone who's been involved in a violent relationship. So one of the things to do is talk about, particularly what I think with young women, about dating, what's responsible, and I think that's a way to make that easier when the things really happen.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for joining us. I appreciate it, and my flowers.
Thank you.
For more information on preteen dating, you can visit danielkids.org.